Greetings, beloved, in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Family, guess what? This is day 10 of what God is doing and what God wants to say to you. I'm bringing you some hope to cope in the midst of this pandemic. In the midst of what's going around us, just some words to ease your troubled mind. Again, good morning, good morning, good morning. It's your boy, Apostle Colonel P. Foy, from the comfort of my home to share word with you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. So we're going to look at two things today right quick, and I'm going to jump off over here. Today we want to look at Proverbs 3, 5 through 6. The scripture said, trust in the Lord with all your hearts and lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him and he will direct your path. I've been on this singing thing lately. I don't know why. So there's an old song that says, trust in the Lord with all of thine heart. And lean not to thine own understanding, but in all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path, and he shall direct thy path. Well, today we want to look at trust. God told me to tell you that he needs you to trust him. So there's a word we use two words we use very interchangeably. Faith and trust, they're very similar, just a slight difference. So I just want to talk about them today, and I'm going to jump into Hebrews chapter 11, that faith chapter, the chapter of heroes. So let's look at this. Faith has to do more with a belief system or the way you believe, while trust is the action or the works of believing. So let's say it again. Faith has to do with our belief system and the way we believe, while trust has to do with the action or the works of our believing. James told him, he said, show me your faith and I'll show you my faith by my works. And so let's go a little bit deeper. That's over in James chapter 2. So for example, faith is believing that God is who he says he is, and that he can do what he says he can do, while trusting is going a little bit deeper, a little bit further, and you're willfully and purposefully and diligently believing that God will do what he promises. Trust is putting the physical effort as a proof of your faith or belief. So if that's why I believe you're a good driver, it will say, put your money where your mouth is and get in the car, let me drive you. If you don't get in there, which means, you know, you have faith, head knowledge, that this person could drive, but you don't trust them enough to carry you. So again, we use those words interchangeably, and we can, but there's a little bit different. Faith has to do with our belief system, and trust has to do with putting action to the faith or showing forth your faith by your action. The Bible said we are to trust God. We have to put some action. We need to, when we say we trust God, people need to know it. Trusting, guess what? If faith and trust in their action words, it would be like you believe in God too for you to get pregnant because you haven't been able to get a baby. You go ahead and buy some baby clothes, buy a bassinet, buy a play-pen, buy a crib and whatever. This, again, you show your faith and your trust in God. Again, trust us into another, taking it to another level. You went ahead and you bought some stuff. So that's like taking it to another level. So when people literally say, no, I have faith in God, you can ask them, do you have head faith? You just believe? Or do you have heart faith, which is faith slash trust? Do you really trust him? If you trust him, we say we trust God, but do we really trust him? We believe that there is a God. So a whole bunch of people are very religious. The Bible talks about they have a form of godliness, but deny the power thereof. Form of godliness, that they believe that there is a God. They deny his power, as in they don't trust in the God. I want to just know, do you have faith in God or do you trust him? Somebody said, well, I do both. Well, are you acting out, especially during this pandemic? Are you trusting God that he can protect you? Your faith is in your action. That guess what? You still do the things that you need to do. Your social distance, however, you boost your immune, you put on your mask, whatever, but believe that he can keep you in the midst of this storm. Not that you're going to go out and just put yourself in harm's way. But are you sitting down thinking that you're going to die? You're already making your will and you should have a will, but you're just ready to quit and throw in the towel? No, 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 no. The Bible said, don't let faith overcome you. Don't let God have to step back on you. Don't begin in faith and then step back. You have to keep trusting him. So we want to go to the next level. So let's go over to Hebrews chapter 11. I just want to share a few things there. Hebrews chapter 11. Hebrews chapter 11. Let's go ahead and start with Hebrews chapter 11. We just want to go right quick. and look at something there, and I promise it will help you. Hebrews 11. The Bible says, no faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. No faith. Again, we have faith here. These people not only had head knowledge, that relationship, trust has to do with relationship. The word trust also is used when, do you trust your husband? Do you trust your wife? Do you trust your husband around other women? Do you trust your wife around other men? It also has to do with faith and trust. So again, that's a word that they use in relationship, not only in marital relationship, but brothers and sisters and friends. Oh, I trust my friend wholeheartedly. You trust them so much that you give them your money, your keys, your business, your whatever. That is thing. This here says, no, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtain a good report. Now the book of Hebrews, again, the book of better things, is the entire thing. They have a better covenant, better Lord, better master, Jesus. I mean, it's just a book of better things, better promises, better things. Now we want to look here that this faith is, their faith is not just head faith. It is heart faith, as in they have faith in God and they trust him. They have the belief system and the action together combined. They trust God. So this is the book of heroes. And I want to just share quickly all these heroes. And if they're placed there to encourage us to not only have head faith, but we need to have heart faith. We need to trust God. When we talk in James said there's dead faith. Faith, you know, faith without works. He said that demonic faith, he said even the demons believe. And he said there's dynamite faith, you know, faith with works, faith with action. And God talked about trust. So let's just put all them together. So let's go ahead. The book talks about 27 spiritual heroes. Now just go ahead and list them. It's a powerful book that should build your faith. It talks about Abel. He was a false martyr in the Bible. His brother Cain killed him. It talks about Enoch walked with God, and he was not, because God took him. He truly was a friend of God. Then after that, it talks about Noah, the righteous man. He preached for 100 years. He was relentless in his faith and trust that God, it was going to rain, and it did. We have Abraham, the father of the Jewish nation and the father of all faith. The Bible said in Galatians chapter 3, 20, if you be Christ, then you Abraham see that as a counter of promise. It goes ahead and it says Sarah, the mother of our, she's the mother of our faith, or a matriarch of our faith. Isaac, he's the Bible, it talks about he was able to abort because of faith, his sons, Esau and Jacob. Jacob, who became our main patriarch, the nation of Israel, is not even named after, is not Abraham or named after Isaac. It's named after Jacob, who God changed his name to Israel. A mighty man of faith. I want to tell you, he had tremendous faith, a tremendous calling, tremendous mantle. The Bible also talks about Joseph, number 8, the interpreter of the dreams, who said, you know what? I tell you, we're going to leap up out of this place. I've already seen the promised land. We're going to leave. And when I leave in, don't leave my body up in here. Number 9, we have Moses. He was the giver of the law. In fact, some places in Israel is so thin that they believe Moses more than God. But Moses was a servant of the Almighty God. Then we have Joshua, who was a successful leader because he was a good follower. He followed his spiritual father, Moses, and that is why he had good success. If you're going to, every good leader must first be a good follower. And again, he's listed here. We have number 11. Rahab, she was saved. Rahab, the whore, she was saved because she helped the spies. We have 12. Gideon, he was reluctant leader. You know, you have to put fleece out. But God used him with the Gideon 300. We've been going through that season to do tremendous work for the kingdom of God. We have number 13. We have Barak, who was commissioned, but Deborah didn't want to go. And he said, I'm not going to go unless you go with me. So Deborah went, and God gave the victory to Jael, who was not even an Israelite. He gave the victory. He said, the woman of God prophesied, you say, because you are so reluctant. Guess what? God is going to give this victory to a woman. We have 14, Samson. You all know Samson was a mighty man of God. You know, his thing was, God told me he was anointed by undisciplined. But guess what? In the end, he repented, you know, and we believe he repented and he committed suicide. You know, but he did great things and great feats for God. We have Jephthah. Again, he's rejected by his family. And you know the stuff that he said, God, if you give me this victory, when I go home, the first thing that comes out, he talked a calf or something would come out, or a lamb. It was his daughter, and he was such an honorable man. My God,
after the daughter got some time to go hang out with her friends and mourn her virginity, not being able to marry, have children, be with her father. That was his only child. He sacrificed her. We have David, amen, the great Sam is the greatest king of Israel, who God said will never cease to be one of your lineage on the throne. Then we have Samuel, amen, the first prophet, priest, ruler and judge, who started the prophetic school, that Gedal anointed seed of Hannah that she prayed into being. Then guess what? Number 18, we have Daniel. Again, that man, he had the interpretation of dreams. He prayed, arise and fall of many kings. The Bible talks about, the Bible doesn't list his name, but he said, you know what? Some lion's mouth was shut on their behalf. Then we had Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. The Bible talks in Hebrews how someone delivered from fire. Those are 20. Then we have Hezekiah. The Bible said, Hezekiah was sick, and when the prophet Isaiah came and prophesied, he turned his face to the wall, and when he cried to the Lord, God told the man of God, go back and prophesy. He said, prove to me that God really said, let him turn the sundial back. And God did it, turning back 15 years. Then we have the woman of Zarephath with Elijah. He restored her son. We have 22. These are the heroes of faith. The Shunammite lady, 2 Kings chapter 4, the man Elisha restored her son. We have Jeremiah. The Bible talks about people that were the people that were cut in their back. Jeremiah was whipped. Hey, my God, in Jeremiah 20. Then we have Zechariah, who was stoned to death. The Bible talks about in Hebrews, those who were stoned to death. And then we have 25. We have Isaiah, who was, history said, was sawn in two. So we can either have 25 or we can have 27 if we break up Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, the three Hebrew boy who ended up in the fiery furnace. So, family, again, these men not only had head knowledge, they had heart relationship with God. They trusted and they believed God, and they acted. Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah said, you know, I could trust in the fire, but that don't mean he's still not God. They believed. Their action was, you can put this in there. He can deliver us if he could deliver us if he want to. If he choose not, he's still God. And he did. So I just want to tell you, family, with whatever is going on in your life, trust God. Trust him. Trust him no matter what's going on, when it seems. You know, I remember I woke up telling God one day, God, I trust you even when I can't trace you. I trust you when I don't even understand. We have to come to the point. We don't understand all that's happening around us with this pandemic, but do you trust God? Not that you just believe him. Do you trust that he's going to bring you out of this storm? Do you trust that he's going to bring you to the other side? Do you trust that you're going to survive this pandemic? I decree and declare that my wife, myself, my child, my mother, my father, my God, everyone attached to me shall survive in the name of the Lord Jesus. But I need you to have faith and trust with me. Stop yourself in your most holy faith. Build up yourself in the most holy faith, praying in the Holy Spirit, according to Jude 9. Build up your faith. Build up your trust. Trust God. Show some action to it. Again, during this time, don't decrease in whatever you are doing. Continue to pay your tithes. Give your offering. Whenever there's church open and you can come to the house of God. Stay in prayer. Stay in the Word. Stay connected. Stay plugged in. And again, whatever it is to do, don't lapse back and don't throw in the towel. Have faith and go to the next level. Trust in God, faith and trust, faith with action. James said, show me your faith and I'll show you my faith by my works. He said, I trust him. So I'm going to play a song by Lauren Dougal. I just love this song. There's multiple songs on trust, but I would just want to trust, sing this song. It always makes me cry. Just let this song encourage you and bless you. Again, let us have faith with God. Let us not only believe that, the Bible said the devils believe and tremble. Let us trust him. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will without fail direct your path. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.